Hi everyone. So let's solve this next question of algebra. Again, a very good question, a very good concept, a concept which you can apply in multiple questions once you learn here. So you write this y is equal to 1 plus x into 1 plus x square into 1 plus x raised to 4 into 1 plus x raised to 8. Okay. Now there's one way here by which you solve such kind of questions. Okay. Otherwise you'll be like in a locked situation, how to solve this. Okay. That is basically I'll multiply by 1 minus x both sides. Okay. So because I need to, this is all plus signs here on right side. No. So what I'll do, I'll try and multiply 1 minus x both sides. Okay. Now that what will happen with that, you can see now. Okay. So you could have observed this earlier also. Okay. That what will happen right now is now minus x and plus x will get combined. That is basically a plus b into a minus b. That becomes 1 minus x square. Hana? And then we have another term of 1 plus x square here. So 1 plus x square, then 1 plus x raised to 4, then 1 plus x raised to 8. Okay. Then I can again multiply these two. So this will become again a plus b into a minus b form. That is again 1 minus x raised to 4 into 1 plus x raised to 4 into 1 plus x raised to 8. Now this will be equal to, again I can multiply these two. So if I multiply these two, that becomes 1 minus x raised to 8 into 1 plus x raised to 8. And finally, it becomes 1 minus x raised to 16. Right. So now y is equal to, I can write this 1 minus x, I can bring down across the other side. So 1 minus x raised to 16 divided by 1 minus x. Now if you remember, there's a simple formula of GP, right? Okay, now what happens in a geometric progression formula? So sum of n terms of GP actually, right? Now what is sum of n terms? If we have like 1 plus x plus, or let's say if we have 1 plus, let's say p plus p square, it's a GP. Okay, so what is sum here? That sum will be first term, that is 1. It should write like this. First of all, if it is like a plus ar square, let me write here. Okay, so a plus ar square till n terms. Okay, so what is the sum? That sum is equal to a into 1 minus r raised to n divided by 1 minus r. If you solve this here, you observe this power 16 here. So if you add till power 16, no, what should be the sum here? So 1 plus p square till p raised to 16 should be first term is 1 only, minus 1 into 1 minus r is p, because every time p is getting multiplied. So 1 minus p raised to 16, because the 16 terms are divided by 1 minus p. So you can see that, right? It is basically 1 se lekar p raised to 16 tak ka sum hai. ये जो वैल्यू है ना ये वाली, दिस इज 1 से लेकर p रेज टू 16 तक का सम है, नॉट 16, आई शुड से 15, राइट? जस्ट अ मिनट, ओके, दिस इज 1 माइनस r, सो इट शुड बी एक्चुअली टिल इक्वल टू p रेज टू 15, दैट विल बिकम 16 टर्म्स, राइट? सो फर्स्ट टर्म इज 1 माइनस, नाउ हाउ मेनी टर्म्स आर हियर? सो इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 1, नो, दैट इज स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम p रेज टू 0 till p raised to 15, so there are 16 terms, right? So 1 minus p raised to 16 divided by 1 minus p. So ye actually kya hai na, 1 se lekar p ki power 15 tak ka sum hai ye. Similarly, what I can write here is actually 1 plus x square se lekar ye aapka x raised to 15 tak ka sum hai. Ye hai aapke y, hai na? So now, agar aapka y yahan pe ye hai, so now what you can calculate here is 1 plus x square till x ki power 15. Now mujhe kya nikalna hai? Sum of the first 5 terms. So sum of first 5 terms kya hoga? So first 5 terms will be 1 plus x square. Huh? Then there will be x cube. And is x raised to 4. And now I just need to put x equal to 4 here. So main yahan pe x ko 4 put kar lunga. So what value I'll be getting? I'll be getting 1 plus 4 plus 4 square plus 4 cube plus 4 raised to 4. That is equal to 256, this value. You can apply GP formula also here. Take care. Now directly because of the short 4, 5 terms, 16 plus 4 plus 1. This is equal to 256, 4, 320, then 340, 341. So 341 is the answer for this question. And that's the concept, right? So basically, this is the main step here. If you can crack it, then this is the first point where people will get stuck. And is second point, basically how to solve from here. So it's a common thing, right? Now you can easily do it, no? So whenever I write like this, you can directly think, for example, if I write here 1 minus a raised to 10 divided by 1 minus a, you directly write, it's basically 1 plus a square till a raised to 9. So 1 minus x raised to 16 by 1 minus x is 1 plus x square till x raised to 15. That is the answer. Okay, 341 is the answer. If you're not made any calculation mistake, 2 raised to 8 is 256. That's fine. 64, 320, 336, 340, 341. Correct. That's the answer. Okay, so I hope all of you got this. Thank you.